Okay guys, first I want to apologize because I thought I had recorded the process of making the mold of Caesar with a clay. I can't remember. I don't think I did. I can't find it anywhere and I don't think I put it on YouTube yet, so I'm sorry. But just to give you an idea how I got the silicone head out, I think it was the part one video shows just the clay. This is not the clay anymore. It's a silicone piece. So imagine this being the clay. What I did is I just, you know, created a wall and brushed on the urethane rubber like that. And I did the same thing in the back with a urethane rubber, brushed it on. As you can see in my past videos, how I do molds. Did some plaster bandages to support it once it was dry. When I took it apart, I took the clay out. Imagine this being the clay. Then on this guy here, I sprayed it with universal mold release. So we would do that, for example. You want to spray it. I put it together. So I now have the piece ready. I don't want to use up silicone, but again, I didn't show you the process, so I apologize for that. And so what I just did is mixed up equal amounts of silicone. I used Plastisil gel number 10, A and B, and I mixed equal amounts. Added some, can't see it, it's all dirty, but it's a tint. It's a, here you go. Silicone pigment to give it some color. Mix it up very well. And again, this isn't enough silicone to fill this up, but I'm just giving you the process of what I did. Again, I apologize for not filming it. And I just poured it in the mold. High up so we avoid the air bubbles. And of course, when the silicone dried, I pried open the mold. And I got this piece. And now to continue with the next part of the video. Now here, again, I didn't record the process, is the part of the chest part. If you remember, it went like that. So I molded this the same way, added the urethane rubber two-piece mold, and I filled it up with resin, which is here. Sounds good. Sharp. And then you have that. So, alright, so I went ahead and did another silicone piece, a little bit darker in the skin tone. And I already cut out the eyes, made big ass holes in there. And I'm going to put these eyes in here. Now, you know, like for example, the cinema kits we have, they don't have glass eyes, which I think, you know, and I wish they should, and they would have done that, but they didn't, and I'm assuming because they think by putting those in there, they may shift or move or whatnot, and then they'll have all these returns. But there is a way to keep them in place and it's actually pretty simple, so you know, maybe they should start putting them in there if they ever start making silicone pieces again, because they haven't done them in a while. So, but here is what I do. I use I use the epoxy sculpt, equal amounts, and I just you know, mix it and put it in there, and that will take the shape of the eye that I will put it in there. Once that dries, it stays in place. So it's actually very simple. So now that it's mixed, we just want to put a whole bunch in there. And we put the eye in there. And push it in position until we see what we like. Alright, so I got the other eye in there, and here we go. Alright, so now that the eyes are hard, we are going to clean the silicone so we can paint it. What's cool about this is that now that the eyes are, the epoxy inside are hard, you can take the eyes out. And that way we don't have to worry about covering them up. See? Took the shape of the inside of the silicone. So when the time comes, I'll just pop them inside. The way they go. What we're going to do now is clean the silicone with acetone, get it ready to paint. Okay, and being that this was made with Plazzo gel number 10, which is this guy here, I'm going to use this to paint him and see what happens. So I have equal amounts. Part A and Part B. Alright, so I'm going to put in the Part B in a big cup because we're going to dilute it, hopefully, so we can airbrush it. And I'm going to add the color here and add some brown to it. I'm going to put in the Part A, and we are going to put, I don't even know how to pronounce this thing, toluene, anyway, that's supposed to dissolve the silicone. And we're going to do two parts of this. I'm well ventilated here because this is not good to breathe. So apparently two parts is all you need to be able to spray it. So we will see. And now we mix. All right, so let's see if it works. Alright, so I added a little darker color to the brown. Alright, so here he is right now. He is a little shiny, but that would be taken care of with powder. Okay, so now it's dry. So that won't be coming off anymore. Now I could add more stuff in there, but I'm thinking, well, the makeup was just really simple and nothing major, like, you know, see-through skin. So let's just keep it at that and see what happens. So let's powder him up, and I'm going to use this translucent powder, and that will take the shine away. And we'll put in the eyes. Pretty cool. So let's get the eyeballs in there. Let me get you a close-up. Eyes are all on there, which is cool looking. So the next step is to put the hair on him, work on this guy here, and get it going.